Hello friends, welcome to ECEJ Squatty channel. Vanakkam, Swagatham, Namaskar. So today we are going to discuss about limitation of conventional mobile telephone system. So why we are using cellular mobile system? See, one of many reasons for developing a cellular mobile telephone system and deploying it in many cities is the operational limitation of conventional mobile telephone system. So what are those limitations? They are limited service capability, poor service performance, and inefficient frequency spectrum utilization. So when we see limited service capability, a conventional mobile telephone system is usually designed by selecting one or more channels from a specific frequency allocation for use in autonomous geographic zones. So what does this mean? So let us take one example. If you take this as one area, and these are zones which we are divided. So zones will be divided in the conventional mobile system. Let us call it as Z1 and Z2. So here one antenna will be there, and here also one antenna will be there. Okay. So here for each geographical areas, that is Z1 and Z2, channels will be allocated. For example, for this Z1 zone, there are three channels allocated, and for this Z2, let us consider there are four channels allocated. So the users who are present here will use this, the subscriber who are present in Z1 use these channels, only these channels, and Z2 use only these four channels, and the fifth one who are calling here, fifth subscriber, he won't get any chance to initiate the call. And the fourth person who is present here, if you want to start the call, he can't get a call. Initiation process won't be there. So this is one limitation. And when the subscriber moves from here to here, the call need to be reinitiated. Then only he can continue in that call. So when he moves from here to here, he need to redial the number, then only he'll get the call. And if these four channels are busy, then the probability of getting chance for him is zero. So this is one drawback in limitation of conventional mobile telephone system. If you take conventional mobile telephone system, the subscriber who is here will be using only these three channels, not other channels. So this is the main drawback which is present in, it can't serve more people. See, the communication coverage area of each zone is normally planned to be as large as possible, which means that the transmitted power should be as high as the federal specification allows. The user who starts a call in one zone has to reinitiate the call when moving into a new zone, because the call will be dropped. And this is an undesirable ratio or radio telephone system, since there is no guarantee that a call can be completed without a handoff capability. So what is this handoff? A handoff is a process of automatically changing frequency as the mobile unit moves into a different frequency zone, so that the conversion can be continued in a new frequency zone without redialing. So another disadvantage of the conventional system is that the number of active users is limited to the number of channels assigned to a particular frequency zone. Okay, this is the limited service capability. We'll go to poor service performance. So in the past, a total of 33 channels were allocated to three mobile systems. So what are those three mobile systems? One is MTS. The second one is IMTS MJ system and IMTS MK systems. So these are three channels which are used. Okay, MTS operates around 40 megahertz and MJ operates around 150 megahertz. And these both system together provides 11 channels. Okay, MK operates at 450 megahertz. This provides 12 channels. So all together as a whole, it provides 33 channels. So this is one example. Here, the actual number of blockings will be there. Although service performance was undesirable, the demand was still great because there are no other systems present. even though the service performance is very low, and even though many customers and subscribers are in blocking list, they use this only because of the great demand. So a high capacity system for mobile telephones was needed. Okay, a high capacitor. See, the large number of subscriber created a high blocking probability. That means in the working hours, we'll be getting more calls. As the number of users and subscribers are limited, the probability of getting a call is also very less. So because of that, a high capacity system for mobile telephones was needed. Okay, then third limitation is inefficient frequency spectrum utilization. So the conventional system does not utilize the spectrum efficiently. Why? In a conventional mobile telephone system, the frequency utilization measurement, M0, is defined as the maximum number of customers that could be served by one channel at the busy hour. So that equation is this. See, number of subscribers divided by number of channels. So the by measuring this only, the frequency utilization will be taken. So each channel can only serve one customer at a time in your whole area. So the measure, the frequency utilization measurement, M0, is defined by the maximum number of customers. So we can call it as M0 or N, whatever the terminology used, you can use. But the formula is the maximum number of customers that could be served by one channel at the busiest hour is the formula for that. So using this only, we will be saying that, okay, this is using a frequency spectrum efficiently or not. So as far as efficiency, a frequency spectrum utilization is concerned, the convention system does not utilize the spectrum efficiently, since each channel can only serve one customer at a time in a whole area. A new cellular system that measures the frequency spectrum utilization is needed. So I'm saying about frequency spectrum analysis utilization. So what actually it is? So spectrum efficiency, so by what considerations they say spectrum is efficiently used or not. So a major problem facing the radio communication industry is the limitation of the available radio frequency spectrum. So as it is, the frequency spectrums are very rare. So this frequency spectrum's cost is high. So in setting allocation policy, the Federal Communication Commission, FCC, seeks system which need minimal bandwidth but provide high usage and consumer satisfaction. So what all the ideal mobile telephone system would operate within a limited assigned frequency band and would serve an almost unlimited number of users in unlimited areas. So three major approaches to achieve the ideals are, see, one is single sideband technique, another one is cellular technique, and spectrum technique. Okay, so first, this single sideband, which divides the allocated frequency band into maximum number of channels. The second one, cellular, which reuses the allocated frequency band in different geographic locations. Spectrum frequency hop, so these which generates many code over a wide frequency band. So anyway, these number of systems are provided. In 1971, the cellular approach was shown to be spectrally efficient system. That is how the cellular approach has started. So that is where we started to use cellular system. And this is the main reasons. And these three, so what are those? Limited service capability, poor service performance, inefficient frequency spectrum utilization. So because of these three major limitations, we are going for high-end systems, that is cellular system. Okay. So the major approaches we have seen it, that is single sideband, cellular approach, spectrum. So those three systems, cellular, which reuses frequency, reuses there in the cellular system. So this is proved in 1971 that this is the maximum efficiency. This is the ideal model. It has been proved. Okay. Thank you. I'll meet you in our next sessions. Okay. Thank you.